Following China's reform and opening up in 1979, traditional Chinese martial arts had a period of immense spread and development.
国家提为下面一个武术处, 让武术处处长赵双进、副处长张山, 他们组织全中国的一些武术家, 干嘛呢? 分一路, 两路, 及三路, 到全国去调研。 国家呢，拿路费，拿生活费，他们去调研，看看这武术各个地方发展怎么样，怎么个情况，回来做汇报。一汇报，哎呀，决定，1979年，在南宁广西南区举办第一次的武术观摩交流比赛大会。那这个事情传得很快呀。 你传我传你，大家知道说五月份要选拔赛，那选拔赛呢？大家伙就摩拳擦掌，就准备了，真的到了五月份，北京市体委进行选拔，然后到南宁去参加比赛去。所以五月份北京市选拔，那我这心情就知道了，我就念了。所以经过选拔，我也被选拔上。
Following China's reform and opening up, this was the first national-level Chinese martial arts competition. The 1979 National Chinese Martial Arts Competition and Exchange was an unprecedented grand event. At that event, approximately 1,000 prominent practitioners from all over China participated, and Liu Jingru became the Bagua Zhang Grand Champion. However, following the event, Liu Jingru was not quite content.
最大的岁数是那年是90岁，黑龙江的刘志清练八卦刀。那时候那个猴王肖英鹏那时候都40多岁50岁的人，又出来了，穿着他那个身黄衣服要参加他那猴拳比赛，那都是过去的猴王啊，所以就硕果仅存的。所以是这些人老武术家们，各省市的这个教授呢，基本上都参加比赛。 所以我都算年轻运动员，年轻运动员，大会平均年龄47岁。
Prior to this competition, Liu Jingru never considered accepting disciples or teaching himself. Following the event, he felt a sudden heavy burden on his shoulders. And at that time, Liu Jingru received an invitation.
由东城区体委群体科科长汤永江当馆长，我李炳慈、王怀、刘洪池、马昌勋，我们5个人当教练，组成东城区武术馆。In
1980, the Eastern District Martial Arts Center was formally established. This was the first such location in China officially opened after the reform and opening up. This was the start of Liu Jingru's new role as a Bagua Zhang teacher.
东城武馆刚成立的时候呢，才七八个班，也就是说，我们还怕招不上生呢。没想到你看我这八卦掌报名的就八九十人，那些怎么教啊？凑合教。
During this period, people who were learning were patient and eager. Liu Jingru was very surprised at the younger generation's passion for martial arts. In the second year of operation of Beijing's East District Martial Arts Center, the number of coaches was increased from 5 to 30. In the third year, due to the popularity of a movie that was released, the center's popularity peaked to an extreme level.
那全国的武术馆如雨后春笋般的，哗哗哗的，那就尤其少林寺电影在演了之后，少林寺那就百十个武术馆啊，这么一个武馆，那么一个武馆，少林寺就是河南的，那处处是武术馆呐，那样，那全国就武术好开展起来了，那真是武术开展，因为那时候年轻人都练肯练武术，因为那时候还没有电脑，还没有。 还没有那个咖啡厅，还没有酒吧间，什么玩的都没有。
Due to Wushu's popularity at this time, Liu Jingru's number of students increased. He was also appointed as a coach of the Beijing Wushu team. Some of his students, such as Ge Chunyan, Zhang Hongmei, Zhuang Hui, etc., won many gold medals at national competitions for Bagua Zhang. After this, Liu Jingru was no longer worried about Bagua Zhang's dissemination for future generations. From the end of the 1970s, Taranting Park became Liu Jingru's primary training location. Many of his students were acquired here.
一般来说，都是我带着我的徒弟那点去年轻的。我带我徒弟有很多人就旁观嘛，旁观他就看着有兴趣，或者跟我用中北京话说套词是吧？用啊，讲一个，一看关系不错，跟我谈起来，要练就练吧。那么有好的我们可以收。
Liu Jingru has said that today many people practice Bagua Zhang for improved health through exercise. The practice of Bagua Zhang can mobilize one's body and energy, as well as the entire body, as a whole body exercise. It has a strong effect on improving health.
我们在练习的过程中，浑身放松，呼吸是自然的，所以这样呢。 它就容易气沉丹田，气沉丹田去啊！你看，我活动都是什么呢？活动的都是掌。你看我一练掌，你看这掌，这手掌全都是红的，说明一练，那个气血全部达到了手上来了。你要看脚呢，也是全部是热的，全部是通红。
In recent times, more and more people come to study Bagua Zhang with Liu Jingru at Taoranting Park, including many foreigners as well.
第一个找到我的是个法国人。 叫郑荣焕，他我不知道他怎么访问到我，他在台湾上的大学，他后来他到了法国去定居法国，法国人了，也不怎么他到北京来找我学了。Most
of Liu Jingru's foreign students opened their own martial arts clubs after returning to their own countries. Through this, Bagua Zhang was disseminated in many different countries.
后来我到法国去教拳，我不会说英语，我更不会法文，我一个人去的，拿行李就下了飞机了。到那地儿就过关了，人问你到这儿来干嘛呢？我怎么说？我说功夫，你一说功夫这来这他们听得懂，仿佛一说功夫这说就当就给你盖上。 仿佛那个时候啊，功夫就是中国的代名词，全世界那学功夫的都到中国来学功夫来，中国就开放了。那么，中国的有些武术家又走出去，又走进来，那所以现在全世界武术开展起来。
In 2009, traditional Bagua Zhang was officially recognized as an intangible cultural heritage within China. This made Liu Jingru extremely happy and excited. Today, his primary focus and goal is to disseminate the art of Bagua Zhang. Although he is almost 80 years of age, he will publish yet another book on Bagua Zhang next year. He hopes through this that the young generation may become interested in the art of Bagua Zhang and begin its study.